Welcome to this week's Quick Charge. Solomon once said, God has planted eternity in men's hearts and minds. God has given every person a unique awareness and an innate knowledge of eternity. So what basic insights might we gain from that? Well, last time we learned that our life on earth is not all there is. Another thing we learn is this: what we do in this life radically impacts the next life. Our earthly life is not separated or segregated from our eternity. We are actually shaping our eternity and our future now. We decide and settle all of that during the here and now. In fact, you can only shape your eternity from this life, from here, never from there. Our only opportunity to do so is now, because eternity is our final destination. So what I ultimately decide about Jesus and what I do about Jesus, whether I decide to believe Him and receive Him and accept Him into my life now, that determines my destination. Jesus said, I am the way, and no man can come to the Father except by me. That's a very narrow and concise statement. There's no wiggle rooms, no ifs, ands, or buts, or maybes. God wants relationship with us now, and also to enjoy that relationship for eternity, but it only takes place through Jesus. So surrendering my life to Him in the here and now, and serving Him and walking with Him, determines my final destination. But it is determined in this life alone. Once I pass into eternity, it's too late. Eternity is also the place of the final distribution. It's very clear from the parables of Jesus that what we do in this life and living for Jesus actually carry over and are transported and transferred and really translate into our forever life. We can make decisions here, we can do things here, make investments here that transfer into reward there. Jesus said, because you were faithful in this, now in this forever life you receive this. Another thing that we gain insight from regarding eternity is this: we must store up for the next life more than for this life. If this life is the dot that we mentioned in part one, and that eternal life is the unending line, then that makes sense. That's wise. It would be unwise to live only for today and for this life only. Wisdom says, don't make accumulating or amassing or acquiring for this life the priority. Don't store up here, but rather store up there. Jesus said just that. Don't store treasures for yourselves on earth, but store treasures in heaven. Your heart will be where your treasure is. So how do we do that? Well, the only way to transfer and exchange from one dimension to the next is by imitating God and doing what God does, and He gives. God changed earth by giving from heaven. We change heaven by giving from earth. Since I can't act like God and act like me at the same time, that's always an act of surrender, faith, trust, and humility. Giving is the only way to store up. It's the only way to send ahead treasures from this life into the next. Remember, when we act like God, then God acts like God for us in our behalf. Stay tuned next week for another Quick Charge. God bless you.